At the launch of the Oculus Quest, 50 games and apps are launched with it. So you might wonder what games and apps should you get first. So in this video we list our 15 personal favorite games and apps that we recommend getting. We will also explain why. This is coming up. Subscribe if you haven't yet to join more VR adventures like this one.
By the way, there is no specific order here, we are just listing the games and apps as we go. Also, please keep in mind that we cannot record gameplay of some of the games in this list yet, so some games are trailers of the PC VR version, those games will look different on the Quest. So, let's get started. Number 1, Big Screen Beta. You liked our last video about watching movies in VR using Oculus Gallery, thank you for that. Now we have another app that is great for doing just that. Big Screen Beta. This app can do anything that we showed in our last video, but what makes Big Screen different is that it's a social experience. Big Screen lets you create customizable avatars so that you can create one that looks just like you. You can invite your friends and family from all around the world into the app to start watching anything together. The screens in Big Screen are massive and fully customizable. And there's cross-platform VR headset support, so you'll be able to watch with other VR users as well. There are also numerous environments to choose from, and the best thing is that right now the app is free. Big Screen is going to be available at the Oculus Quest launch like any other games and apps that we are going to mention in this list. Please know that this list might change as time goes on. Number 2, Apex Construct. Apex Construct is a story-driven single-player adventure puzzle game. In Apex Construct, you enter a world where humankind has gone extinct. Your task is to find out what happened while wielding an upgradable cyber bow and shield combination. Soon in the game, you will find out that enemies are AI robots trying to destroy anything that comes into your path. You will be mostly exploring and trying to find out how to get from one room to the other by finding passcodes and keycards, while occasionally coming across robots. It's then up to your bow and arrow skills to stay alive. The story itself is mostly told through little notes that you can find in the world, but there are also voice actors who tell the main story. Apex Construct has cartoonish graphics, but it looks very beautiful. The world is based on Stockholm, where the developers are from, and I think those kind of little details are just awesome. Having played the PC VR version and the Quest version, I am quite surprised that this game plays the same as on PC VR. I think this game has a great combination of slower moments with more fast-paced action. I would recommend it if you like this combination too. Number 3, Moss. Moss is an adventure platformer in VR. You play as a friend of the tiny mouse called Krill. It is your mission to help her save her uncle and hopefully the world too. Moss is a very popular and highly praised VR game in the PC VR community, so knowing that this game is coming to the Quest is absolutely awesome. In the game, you will see Krill in third person. You control her using classic controls, the joystick and the A plus B buttons to fight and jump, for example, but in VR it does not stop there, because you will have to use your hands to interact with the environment, to create roads or to protect your little mouse. It is a multitasking experience and that can get pretty difficult sometimes, but the challenge is a ton of fun, and soon you will actually create an emotional bond with Krill, which is really incredible work by the developers. Hats off to Polyarc. This game can be played perfectly comfortable, seated, and we highly recommend you to get this game straight away. Number 4, Super Hot VR. If you ever want to feel like Neo from The Matrix, then Super Hot VR is probably the game that comes the closest to it. You probably already know this game since it was a popular game as a flat game as well. But for those that don't know it yet, it is a VR FPS and action game where you control time. As you move, time moves with you. It is you outnumbered against the enemies, but you can use almost anything that you can find as a weapon. Be prepared to dodge, punch and sweat your way through this game. There is no health bar too, so once you get shot or hit, you will have to start over at the checkpoint. It is a game that can be played fast-paced or as slowly as you would like. This is a game that you used to play stationary, but now with the Quest you can move around in the space as well. This is a great game to start with since it is easy to understand and a great game to show off VR to others as well. Number 5. Orbis VR. Orbis VR was the first MMORPG game in virtual reality. If you like the anime Sword Art Online, then this game is probably the closest you can get to it. This game was successfully funded on Kickstarter a long time ago, but they have just recently released a huge update called Reborn, and this is the version that comes to the Quest. It has now new graphics, new classes, and quests. It has anything you would expect from an MMORPG, and you can even raise your own dragon pet. Be prepared to spend tons of hours in the avatar customization and then start grinding your way up in levels while battling tons of different monsters with others online. Once you are ready, you can try your luck at the dungeons or public events. There is a lot to do. This is the only game that has ever gotten us so far to play it 6 hours straight without a break in VR, and for those that are new here, 6 hours without food and drinks can be pretty draining, so we don't recommend that. The best thing about Orbis VR right now is that if you play it on PC VR, you can just continue playing using the Quest, since it has cross-platform support. We highly recommend Orbis VR if you like to play MMORPGs. Number 6. Beat Saber. Need we say more? I don't think so. Get ready to get your groove on while slashing up boxes with your lightsabers. This is the game we are definitely getting straight away, since we have been using Beat Saber as a workout too. But this is also just a great game to show off VR to any friend, even the non-gamer ones. Number 7. Shadow Point.
Alex, my name is Edgar Mansfield. On July 1st, I arrived at the summit. And if you're reading this, I never returned.
Shadow Point is a story-driven puzzle game, and it is narrated by Sir Patrick Stewart, which is just cool. In Shadow Point, you are on a mission to uncover the mystery of missing schoolgirl Lorna, who vanished 12 years ago. Sounds scary, but it is definitely not a scary game. It is pretty slow-paced and awards exploration. A lot of times you might be just looking around, enjoying the views. We tried this game out at PAX East and thought it was a beautiful, well-made game. It has a lot of puzzles and some can get quite challenging, so you definitely need to like puzzle games if you want this one. But if you are a puzzle lover, then this is a good one to start with. And the game is cross-buy on the Rift platform with the Quest, so if you have a Rift 2, you can play on both platforms. While you're watching this video, please leave a like if you enjoyed this video so far. Number 8. Dance Central. The name says it already, this is a VR rhythm game that encourages you to do dance battles. In the game, there is an avatar in front of you that shows you the moves which you have to copy. Many popular songs are on this game, like Turn Down For What by DJ Snake and Lil Jon, or Vanessa by Bruno Mars. We think this is going to be a great party game, and maybe as well for a workout. It can maybe even teach you a move or two. We like it. Number 9. Rec Room. Rec Room is a social VR game, and we always mention this game because it is free. And while it is free, it is so polished. In Rec Room, you can create an avatar and then enter social areas to meet people all around the world, or invite your own friends into your own created rooms to hang out. When you feel like it, you can play numerous multiplayer games like paintball or Rec Royale. There are also co-op quests, which are challenging adventures that you can play mostly with up to 4 friends. And those quests are definitely not easy and will take skill and cooperation to finish. If you don't feel like those intense games, then there are also numerous casual games to play too, like 3D charades or disc golf. This game is a ton of fun, especially with friends. We highly recommend downloading it. Number 10. VR Chat. VR Chat is another social VR game, but it does not have a lot of mini games. Instead, it is more of an exploration, wander around, and talk with everyone kind of social game. It's like a next level chat room where you are able to interact with people and the environment. Plus, instead of typing, you just speak to them. What makes VR Chat different is that you can import your own 3D character designs, and you can even create your own worlds for others to explore. When you enter VR Chat, it is always an adventure, since you always bump into something random. Since VR Chat can be played without a VR headset too, it is also always busy, so the player base is definitely not a problem. If you are into this kind of social experiences, this is a recommendation. Number 11, Journey of the Gods. Journey of the Gods is a new game that is created for the Oculus Quest and Rift S. It is an action-adventure game where you are armed with a sword and shield and crossbow. You'll fight various fantasy monsters from small to so huge that you are thinking, whoa, what is this, before you start a battle. The game uses virtual reality mechanics smartly and can make you feel either small or huge like a god. I think the developers make great use of skill in this game. The game consists of a fantasy world that feels very big, so you'll be exploring and walking around while meeting NPCs that feel like people. They speak gibberish, but using little speech bubbles and facial expressions, you'll know what they are talking about. They will give you quests for you to complete, and those feel very satisfying. It is a cute and fun adventure that feels like an RPG, which is your favorite game genre. If you like adventure games too, then definitely get this one. Number 12, Robo Recall. Robo Recall is a frenetic first-person shooter. This was a very popular game not only because it came for free with the Oculus Rift, but also because it is a very, very polished and beautiful game. In Robo Recall, you are tasked to recall rogue robots while unlocking an expanding arsenal of weapons. It is a very high-paced, action-packed game, and the VR mechanics are absolutely well done in this one. You can interact with a lot in this world, like you can grab the robots, rip their arms apart, and then throw that arm at a robot, for example. You can even catch bullets and then throw the bullets back at the enemy. This game is just very satisfying to play. Definitely check out this game if you have the chance. Number 13, I Expect You to Die. I Expect You to Die is an action puzzle game. Here, you are an elite secret agent that possesses telekinesis powers. Of course, you must attempt to survive deadly situations in dangerous environments. You have to complete each mission using problem-solving skills and wits. Use whatever you can find to escape each situation or die trying. It's a fun game to play. Can get difficult sometimes, but it's a lot of fun and well made. You don't need the space to walk around. It is mostly made for stationary play spaces. The devs recommend you to play this game while seated, so it is a very comfortable game. If you want to see what this game is like, we will be live streaming this game on the Oculus Quest this Saturday at the time of posting this video. Number 14, Tilt Brush. After all that action, you sometimes just want to relax, and Tilt Brush is just the app for that. In Tilt Brush, you can paint anything you want in 3D space. So your play space is your canvas, and you can get many different brushes and shaders, from fire to paper to rainbows. There's a lot to choose from for your creativity, and you can create really amazing things without even needing the skill to draw. I really recommend trying drawing out in VR because it is so easy to create 3D drawings in VR, since you can actually move your hands in front of you to create depth, for example. And after you create something, you can just walk around it to view it at every angle. It is just so much fun and relaxing. I recommend trying this out while turning on a YouTube video or a relaxing song. Tilt Brush was actually also one of our first apps we ever tried in VR, and it sold us on VR immediately. Number 15, Virtual Reality. Virtual Reality is a comedic science fiction VR game about artificial intelligence. It is narrative driven and is set in a future where AI has transformed society. You are a human, and the robots are letting you help them in increasingly curious ways. The game says it already, but it is a very meta game, since you'll be entering different worlds inside this world by putting on a VR headset inside VR. I think it is a really fun way of showing how immersive VR can be. So in this game, you'll be mostly solving comedic puzzles by entering one world, and once you've solved that, you'll be back in the main area where you can select another level. There are over 50 worlds to explore here, and they are all really funny. We really recommend this game if you like a laugh while playing a game. This is the end of the list, but it is not over yet, so don't leave yet. We also wanted to mention 4 Oculus apps that are free to install as well straight away, which are 1. Oculus Browser to browse websites and web VR with, 2. Oculus Gallery, Oculus's native VR video and photo viewer that we showed in the last video, And 3, Oculus TV, Oculus' hub to launch entertainment apps like Netflix or Hulu. And 4, Oculus Video, the official Oculus Video app.
Are these the games and apps you would download too? If not, which apps do you recommend as well? Let us know down below. A special thanks goes to Art Armand and a special shout out goes to his Patreon page. Everyone, thank you all so much for your support by watching, and as always, VR on! And this is, oh, oops. This is the Oculus Quest.